either you were due out last April, or you've got another 27 and a half years to serve. Never mind, we'll ask Davo, but she'll probably give you an extra couple of months for all the time you spend in the loo.
Oh, come on, B, this is bloody serious. I could be serving extra time in here and I don't even know it.
Well, isn't this nice? Everyone's having a wonderful time. What do you find so amusing, Mason?
Nothing.
Well, wipe that stupid grin off your face. Come on, get back to work, the lot of you. It seems to be your problem, Burns.
I'd like to see Mrs. Davidson.
Beg your pardon?
I'd like to see Mrs. Davidson, please, Miss Ferguson.
Well, I don't think she particularly wants to see you, Burns.
Yeah, well, I'd like to see her because I'm due out of here any day now and I'd like to know exactly when it is.
You'll be told at the appropriate time.
I want to know now. I've got to organise my party.
I said you'll be told on the day.
That's not fair. I've got plans to make.
How does an extra couple of days sound to you, Burns, for disobeying an order? Now get rid of that rubbish and get back to work.
Bloody great bitch. I reckon it's still just got to be a few days until I get released. It's just got to be.
Don't you ever let up, Doreen. Trevor's mad at lunch. It can't be. They will let you know by now. Davo always gives a long term as a bit of notice.
Well, maybe she's forgotten this time.
You don't think she keeps it in her head, do you? It's on file. The department would notify her as well.
Well, you know what they're like. They've probably lost my file. I could be in here forever, and you know what'll happen then. They'll blame the rotten computers.
Okay, Mason, Inspector Grace is here. Come on, you wanted to see him. You're going straight to the court after the interview, too.
Wish me luck, will you?
Come on. Now, come on, Mason. You're wasting my bloody time. I need names, I need dates, and I need places.
I've got to get something out of this. If I'm going to nail these people, it's got to be worth my while.
I think you're trying to con me. I don't think you know anything worthwhile. I think you're about as bloody useless as that Susie Driscoll.
She's just a kid. She doesn't even know where it's at, let alone where to put it. Des wouldn't have let her know anything important. I've been around longer. I promise you, I know things and I've seen people.
There you go again. What things? What bloody people?
I've got to get something out of this. You know what I want.
Yes. Yes, I know what you want. But what you get depends on me.
All right. I'll give you a list of names and I'll even tell you where they keep the stuff. What's that worth to you?
All right, I'll tell you what I'll do for you. I'll personally take you to the sister and make sure you get all the medication you need to get you through.
What if she doesn't play ball? Well,
then I'll bring in a doctor from the outside who will.
I want the real stuff.
Real stuff? You get medication or you get nothing. Now use your bloody head. You know what it's like to come out of this cold turkey?
Yeah. I want $50 too. It's not for me, it's for a friend, okay?
Oh, Jesus. $50. What for, to buy drugs? You've got to be joking. I've gone as far as I'm going to go with you already.
It's a deal.
Good girl. Now, just one other thing. You give me the names, you give me the places, and you're going to have to testify in court. Now, it's no good you giving me all this information if I can't nail the bastards. And, of course, it'll be a lot safer for you, too.
As long as you do what you say. Might as well go out on a high.
Oh, I'm sick of this. Somebody else can do the next load.
Yeah, maybe we could get Maxine in from the garden. She's had a pretty easy day.
Yeah, I'd like to shove her in with a load of sheets.
And her girlfriend.
Ooh, I know what I'd like to be shoving.
Oh,
yeah, cool. Right. Need a few of you out there to help unload the laundry truck. Smith, Latham and you, Stokes. And what's amusing you, Simpson?
Nothing, Miss Ferguson.
Let's see if you can get a laugh out of cleaning the toilets.
But I didn't do anything wrong.
Oh, you three. Mr. Faulkner's waiting for you at the security gate. You? Come with me.
Where to?
I just told you, the toilet block.
Can't I clean out somewhere else?
Well, you're frightened of getting your nice little hands grubby. Don't worry, you'll be safe. But life could have been a lot easier for you if you'd been a bit smarter at the start. Now move.
Oh, I've got to lose some weight. Every time there's a heavy job, I get lumbered with it because I look bigger and stronger than everyone else. Hey, a gander at Ferguson's fag. You'd think she was recuperating from an operation.
Okay, Daniels, you can cut the act. Wouldn't want you to exhaust yourself, would we?
Get inside. Pack your things. You're being released.
I'm getting out! Ben, bloody Jesse!
Excuse me.
Lucky bugger.
Don't worry, she'll be back. Her sort always is. But I give a week's buy-up to find out how she got round Ferguson.
Yeah. Come on, you lot, get a move.
Oh, all right, all right. Well, well. I wonder if she'll live long enough to make it back
Inspector
here.
Inspector Grace.
Oh, that bastard will feed her to the wolves when he's finished with her.
Yeah, I know he's a mongrel, Chrissy. But he's about the only chance she's got at the moment. At least he'll look after her while he thinks she's got something he wants.
Hiya, scrubber!
God, Maxine almost had a fit.
Why did you think it was? The bear.
I don't know, I just got a fright, that's all. Anyway, who's the bear?
Ferguson. Who else?
We call her the freak.
Yeah, I know. Well, I call her anything I can get me tongue to. The bear, the freak, dickhead.
God, you're a trick, Maxine. You're a bright spot around here, you really are.
Yeah, well, not for long, sweetheart, because this little one's about to walk right out the door.
You lucky bugger, how come?
I'm having it off with Davo.
God, doesn't anything worry you?
Nah. Secret to my success. Never let the bastards get you down.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Yeah. Anyway, see you, love.
Bye.
You've been having a bit of trouble with Fergo lately, haven't you?
Well, why do you think I'm cleaning the toilets?
Well, I do have one other secret to my success.
Yeah?
And it's all to do with keeping Fergo under control. I don't think she'd mind if I shared it with you.
Well, they finally unloaded the laundry van. Not the fastest operation I've ever seen.
Doesn't surprise me.
I hear we're losing Daniels.
Yep, good riddance. I think if she'd been here much longer, she just might have met with a nasty accident.
Was she upsetting some of the women?
Who else?
Well, where's the farewell committee and the brass band?
Where is?
Oh, I thought at least the governor would be here to shake me hand and tell me how much she's gonna miss me.
She sends her love and hopes you had a good stay. Sign here.
Well, it hasn't been so bad, yep. As a matter of fact. Quite a surprise meeting up with old friends. Useful too.
I'm wanted over in C block.
Oh, see ya.
Listen to me, you little slut. Don't you think for one minute that you've got the upper hand on me. It was worth doing business with you because you were only here for a short stint. But believe me, if you ever come back, it'll be a whole new ball game.
Thanks for the tip, Butch. There was... Oh, yeah. I got one for you, too. I dropped our little secret to one of the other girls.
Who?
For her to know, and you to find out.
Right, Simpson, on your feet. I'm putting you on a charge.
What for? What to do this time?
Well, I've just inspected the shower block that you're supposed to have scrubbed.
Yeah, I did.
Looks like a badly kept brothel.
Then you should feel right at home, shouldn't you?
Oh, little Miss Purity's finally found some guts. Or are you just feeling lucky?
Not lucky. Just prepared. Maxine gave me a little going-away present about when she knew you in Queensland.
Oh, so you're the one.
Now, I let Daniels get away with that for a while because she was only in here for a short time.